I'm Kevin Hogan, president of Rock Island Auction Company, and welcome to our September 9th, 10th, and 11th Premiere Firearms Auction. The sale is hard to describe in words. From iconic collections, which include the Robert Brotherton collection, of course, the Robert M. Lee collection, the finest firearms collection ever assembled, the Thor Edgeberg collection, the John Bill collection, the names are endless and so are the guns. From prototypes from Winchester, Webley, and Colt, to presentation Walthers, presentation Winchesters, fine sporting arms, you name it, we have it in the September 9th, 10th, and 11th premiere sale. This is an honor to sit down and talk about this specific gun, which represents so much more. This is one of the icons. This gun is one of the icons of not just Winchester collecting, but American firearms collecting, for two reasons. One, this is one of the cornerstones of the Robert M. Lee collection. It was one of Mr. Lee's favorite guns, and for obvious reason. But two is the fact that it is unbelievably fresh. To my knowledge, it has never been sold publicly. This is the first time it's going up for auction. The gun has traded hands maybe three times in the last 35, 45 years. So not a lot of people have owned it, but a lot of people have drooled over it. This thing is pictured in at least five or six of the really great key Winchester books. And I don't want to understate this. It's one of the greatest 19th century American firearms period. It is properly known as the Three Graces Winchester 1866 musket, and we'll get into that in a little bit, but the Three Graces represent beauty, charm, and grace, and of course, so does this musket. So we can dive into the gun, what makes it special. I'll tell you a little bit about the history. The gun is said to have been presented to Michigan Senator Thomas Witherell Palmer. He was obviously a prominent senator from Michigan. He was in charge of the World Columbian Exhibition in Chicago. He was the head of the commission, started in 1890, and the fair was, of course, in 1893. And he was also one of the founders of the Detroit Museum of Art. So a very prominent individual was presented this musket. What makes this gun really special is, of course, the condition and ultimately its configuration. Now, some real heavy Winchester collectors will look at it and say, well, it's a musket. Well, they're hitting the nail on the head. It is a musket, and that's what makes it so special. There are a lot of, though there's not a lot of, but there's factory engraved 1866 carbines. Of course, there's factory engraved 1866 rifles, but there are so few factory engraved 1866 muskets. And well, let's just dive into this gun because that's what makes it so special. It's all in the details. You see the deluxe wood. And notice the lines. Notice how sharp and crisp the lines are on the wood. And when you get into the frame, this is what really sets this gun apart. It is relief engraved. There are six panel scenes on this gun. The right side, you have a mythological beast, a very unique scene. This is the only time the scenes can be seen on a Winchester. It's kind of a fantasy scene of a horse and a ballerina. And then we have a deer standing in the other panel scene, flipping the gun over, and this is the side of the gun. This is the panel scene that makes this gun absolutely extraordinary. You can see why they call it the Three Graces. Very, very prominently in relief, right in the center of the frame, you have the Three Graces. The elephant, extremely iconic. I don't know of another 66 or another Winchester factory engraved with an elephant on it. The gun was executed by Conrad Ulrich. It is signed twice on the lower tang. The gold is all there. It is all there throughout the frame, the butt plate, only the slightest traces from storage. I'm gonna flip it back over and we'll look at the loading gate, but it's all in the details. Look at the loading gate. Look how bright the loading gate is. You know there's no cartridge has slipped through there. Look at the hammer. Look at the case color on the hammer. This is what makes this not only one of the best Winchesters, but one of the finest 19th century American arms. And if you're a student and you've gone through the books, and you'll know this gun. It is in five or six books, but it's never been out. and this is the chance. This is your chance to see it. This is your chance to own it. As I said, it was one of the cornerstones of the finest firearms collection ever assembled. And let's set it off a little bit more. It is factory cased. And look at this case. I'm gonna put the musket in here, but a beautiful factory case with the red that really, really accent it. But this is a one of one. Don't get it confused. A one of one factory engraved, factory cased Winchester 1866 musket. Again, an icon for all time. And this is really, really just the beginning. We took a lot of care, a lot of time into making sure that we, with the combination of the Brotherton collection, the combination of the Lee collection, posed quite a problem. There are so many, not good things, there are so many great things. So we've taken a lot of care and custody in planning these auctions, now and in the future. And we thought this was an appropriate piece to start off with because we're so confident in it. We're so happy to have it that it's one of these icons that is now coming out. It's now coming out for the collecting and investing public to have a chance to see, to have a chance to own. So I can't encourage you enough to come to the sale September 9th, 10th, and 11th. The preview is September 8th. We make a special effort into making our September preview an event worth attending. We bring in a live band, we have great food, great music, great guns, and of course, great company. And really, this is just the beginning. We're gonna talk some more about some wonderful Winchesters from not only the Robert M. Lee collection, but the Brotherton collection, from the Edgeburg collection. We'll talk about those. But Winchester is really only the beginning, as you guys have come to know. The Colts are phenomenal. U.S. military is phenomenal. German military is phenomenal. Probably the greatest assembly of fine, high art, European wheel locks, percussion guns that have ever come to auction will be featured in this sale. Sporting guns galore. It is totally endless. So please, if you're considering coming, mark it on your calendars now. It's going to be worth your while. This auction is going to be remembered for many years to come. Hope to see you in September.